back again with more World Cup for you guys. We got Shake versus Jimmy Tervik this time. So I brought Mega Scizor Balance. Yeah, I think it's more balanced than Bogeyovins. So sometimes I'm a little confused why people run Slowking over Slowbro. I know some people run it for style points, but in a tour game, it's probably not for style games. For style points. I'm wondering if it's AV Slowking. Because, like, one thing that Slowking obviously has over Slowbro is better speed death. So, if you run AV, it's really speed death bulky. So, if the trend is offensive, or maybe he wants some speed death switch in and the Slowking's AV. Yeah, let me look at Jimmy's team. Mew puts in a ton of work. I think his main way of breaking Mew is the Manaphy or the potential Toxic from the Heatran. Yeah, Heatran on Shake's side can be really nice to prevent the Mew from clicking Will-O-Wisp on the Scizor potentially. Like, he always is scared to click Will-O-Wisp because he doesn't want to give the Heatran a Flash Fire boost. Even though he has his own Heatran, Heatran's carry off power, kinda. In Aura, it's not that often, I think, but like in Sun and Moon, I see it a lot at the moment. In Aura, I haven't seen it that much. Like, I see a lot of Toxic Taunt Heatran, at least from what I remember. And they carry like Lava Plume about over Magma Storm. What is the Scarf on Jimmy's team? Kelio specs most of the time, but his team is kind of slow. These are Scarf Kelio or Scarf Landorus, I assume. And then Rockstren. The Mew, I assume, is either the Stall Breaking set or Defogger. Like, his team is not really weak to hazards, and he has a Diancie to potentially avoid hazards. I know Diancie is not really reliable, but it still somewhat helps to make the opponent not click rocks every time. We saw the other day that Shake didn't care and he clicked rocks and it didn't work out because Nintendo even hardened Diancie. That was wild. I can see Jimmy leading off with Kelio. Like, Kelio puts in some work. Like, it matches up versus the majority of Shake's team, and he can just try to Scald Burn the incoming Slowking. Yeah, so I don't. They're taking a long time. Finally, they started a timer like a while ago already. Like, I've realized some World Cup games didn't have timer on for some reason. So he just leads off with Diancie, which makes me think he's Protect 100, like, obviously, that most Diancie carry Protect. And if the Scizor has SD, that would be a nice flex play turn 1. But he just goes for U-turn. So some Diancie carry HP Fire, so I could see Shake just clicking Bullet Punch. Because he might not want to play around with HP Fire Diancie, even though the Scizor can obviously live it. Would be really annoying for him if Scizor takes the huge hit. So, I'm not really sure if this will have HP Fire because he has a Heatran. And Tangros that carry HP Fire kind of often in Auras. I assume he goes for U-turn again, which is a risky play, but it works out. I mean, it was kind of obvious to switch into Heatran, but you never know. If the Diancie had HP Fire, like, there's always the risk of taking a huge hit on a Scizor and not doing much back to the Diancie if you U-turn, but it obviously paid off, and he can bring in his Manaphy or his Landorus here. Even Heatran would scare the opposing Heatran out, because he could be like Scarfed Run with Earth Power and bluff that. Like, if he brings in the Tran, he sees that this Tran has leftovers. Jimmy will be scared out by potential Earth Power, I assume, because he doesn't know if this is Scarfed Run, but Shake, I assume. Like, I assume both players have rocks Heatran, to be honest. But you never know, because sometimes people run it the other way around, where it's rocks on Landorus and Scarf on Heatran. Scarf Tran is not even that. It has not the worst speed here. It's not super fast, But I think it outspeeds Mega Lopunny by 1 point, if I recall correctly. But yeah, Duskside going to Manaphy, and this is a huge threat. The Heaton does show leftovers as expected. So I can see Jimmy either going hard into Kelly or into... If he's AV Tangrowth, he can go into Tangrowth, but good lord, Manaphy's a threat. Yeah. Wow, if he's handled Tangrowth, his Manaphy's a huge problem. I mean, he can obviously revenge it with Secret Sword into Moonblast or Diamond Storm, but like, it's still a big threat, and it's not like Shake can't switch out on Diancie or Keldeo into Slowking. He goes for Tail Glow, so I assume this has either Psychic or Energy Ball. I assume it's three attacks. Is he weak to stall? Let me see. Because if he's weak to stall, Renance would make some more sense. But Ren could be a set that helps versus stall, but he's kind of weak to stall, so I could see this being Rain Dance. Which means he might not have a courage move for the Keldeo, but like at first I thought he has one, but I'm not sure anymore. But even on the Rain Dance set, I see Manaphy run Psychic sometimes. Like I've seen Scald Rain Dance, Tail Glow, and Psychic on the same moveset. Yeah, he does have Energy Ball, Keldeo goes down, so I assume Shake just does have Ice Beam, Energy Ball, and Scald on this. He's obviously in range from this, the Yancey. So I'd probably go for Diamond Storm here from Jimmy Turtwig because it hits the Scizor harder than Moonblast. And it hits the Slowking probably harder too. And Shake should save this, right? Because it can still put in some work. So I'm pretty sure that this Tangrowth is Rocky Helmet, because otherwise, if he's Leaf Storm Tangrowth, I think he should have gone to that over the Keldeo. But let me open my calculator for later scenarios where we might need that. And click on X, Y, because I don't want to run wrong calcs for Sun Moon meta. Like most calcs the same anyway, but the Sun, the X, Y calculator has all the aura sets. Basically, the sets that are more common in auras. It's either go Slowking or go Scizor. He goes in Heatran predicting the Scizor, really nice play, which confirms that he probably doesn't have HP Fire on his Diancie. Or it also makes me think that he has Toxic on his Heatran because he predicted the Scizor slash Slowking. So if the Slowking came out, he wanted to Toxic that, and if the Scizor comes out, he can threaten that out. I can see Jimmy getting his rocks up. Either getting up his rocks or going for Toxic predicting the Slowking switch. Rocks is just a safe play. I assume the Scizor is just gonna be Ashley Roost, U-turn Bolt Punch. I don't think it will be Super Power, because the Super Power set usually is a fast Scizor with a Bug Bite. They don't really carry U-turn most of the time. So he gets the Mana Fiend, which is cool play. He gets more leftovers. I could see him just clicking Scald here, because if Jimmy switches hard into the end, like, you just wanna... Scald basically doesn't lose you anything. You probably 2-hit KO the Heatran. Maybe Spadefstran can even lift 2 Scalds. But if the turn is like max HP, max speed, you probably 2-hit KO with Scald. And like, you get revenge by the NC anyway, so I don't think there's a point in setting up a Tail Glow. And if Tang with his helmet, it even takes a lot from Scald. And you know Scald is a broke move, you always get the chance to burn something, so it's not like you lose anything from clicking it here. I mean, I can see Jimmy staying in a Toxic and predicting like Tail Glow, or if he's Spadef, he can eat up Scald. But I'm not really sure, man. His Manaphy is just a huge problem for him. He goes hard into Tangrowth, and I think he's AV. Wow, I thought he was not AV because he didn't go into it the first time. I want to actually calc if Leaf Storm Oko's Manaphy from full, because that might be the reason why he didn't go into Tangrowth the first time. Maybe he only has Giga Drain, which doesn't Oko Manaphy. What the fuck does it say, Bombas? I wanted Manaphy in the calc. Leaf Storm does 89 to 105, so the first time it wouldn't have killed, and plus 3 Ice Beam would have probably 2-hit KO'd. Yeah, plus 3 Ice Beam easily 2-hit KO'd. So Shake doesn't get the burn. If this doesn't have HP fire, this is a free switch into Scizor. So I can see Jimmy doubling back into like something that covers the Scizor. But he just goes for knockoff and gets rid of the Scarf, which can come into play later on, because Landorus losing Scarf means it's slower than Diancie and slower than opposing Scarf trend. So I assume that... Oh, by the way, this guy said I totally skipped class to watch some quality World Cup content. You don't have to skip class, I record all the games for you guys. But yeah, I know that some people obviously wanna watch the game live on Smokeless and like see chat and everything. That's completely fine with me. But yeah, if you do miss it, you can like check it out on my channel. I'll cover as many Aurora and Sun and Moon games as possible. Like the other day I covered so many games I didn't even get that many views because people can't follow, I assume. I think I uploaded 6 or 7 games yesterday. But he gets rid of the Assault Vest, which helps his man if he become an even bigger threat. U-turn. So if this Tangus has HP fire, this is the turn to go for it. He showed Earthquake. So Earthquake, Knockoff, and then Gigadrin slash Leaf Storm. And the last move is probably a Hidden Power I assume it's Hidden Power Fire. And he goes Scizor. Does he go for Hidden Power Fire? He just goes for Gigadrin Psy. That would have been fire if he went for HP Fighter. I mean, I still see HPIs and auras a lot, even on Tangrowth. But HP Fire is an option, like... I mean, he's not that weak to Scizor, he has... He just U-turns out, and this is probably a Scarf Landorus, because it took 12%. Yeah, he's not that weak to Scizor, that's what I was trying to say earlier. He turned and killed you. You can Whirlwisp Scizor. So that makes sense that he doesn't have HP fire on Tangrowth, probably. I assume it's gonna be HP ice then. Because his team... It's not super weak to Zard. I guess Zard Y is a threat, so I can see... Rock Slide is another option that I could see. But I'm leaning more towards HP ice. But he gets in the Brillomere. And the Tangrowth is super low, which means it's not really a switch in. I could see him going for SD. And if the Mew doesn't run enough speed to creep this Brillium, this is gonna be annoying for Jimmy. But I think Brillium should... A Mew should carry enough speed to speed creep Brillium. But I'll check the standard spread at the... how much speed Mew has to run to what speed Brillium. We'll check that real quick. I mean, I can also see him going for Spore here. Predicting the Mew to come out. Because I assume you will run enough speed. I think there was like some spread. How much speed was it? Was it like 150? Okay, so Jolly Brillium hits 262, which means... Yeah, 108 speed, Mew outspeeds Jolly Brillium. I think that's pretty much the standard. Like, Mew at least runs 108 speed to outspeed Jolly Brillium and Bisharp. And they might even run a little bit more speed sometimes to speed creep stuff that speed creeps Brillium and Bisharp, basically, yeah. Yeah, I think he's gonna go into... If he predicts a Spore, he's gonna pivot from Tangrowth into Mew, potentially. Because Tangrowth has probably HP Ice, so Brillium won't be able to SD on that, and then he can pivot into Mew from that if he gets the play correct. Oops, I just hit my mic. I hope you didn't hear that too loud. But yeah, ABR is going to be playing later, so that's pretty hype. I think in like 90 minutes. He just go for Bullet Seed, and I think, yeah, I was about to say that's probably Life Orb damage. Because that Bullet Seed did a ton. I assume this Mew is going to be a little bit more Fist Def orientated, because his Tangrowth is already Assault Vest. But we will calc that real quick, Bullet Seed. Yeah, versus Spit Def Mew. 3 hits will do 58 to 70, so yeah. Wait, why does it do so much? That's weird. I guess it's technician boosted and Brillium is not to be underestimated. It still has 130 base attack. And it's life orb. But I assume the Mew is like bold with like maybe like 152 or something in defense. And not 252. That's just some, like not exactly 3 hits but 274 to 47 to 55. So I think the Mew might even be more bulky. What, that both 17 and 18. Yeah, nah, he could be about that spread, 152 in defense. About that, like something along those lines. And the Imbruglim just got like kinda low rolls or mid rolls on the bullet seed. But he does show taunt, so his other moves I won't be always softboiled, and then it's either knockoff. Like knockoff is a lot more common in Auras than in Sun and Moon on Mew. He does just go for Lava Plume. I assume his other moves are Stealth Rocks and Toxic, and then it's either taunt or Earth Power. It could also be Stone Edge because he's kind of weak to Zardwai, but we don't know the Slowking yet. If the Slowking set could also be able to deal with Zardwai if it's Assault Vest, like it could check Zardwai. It's not a super good counter, but it can like check it somewhat. But he goes hard into Landers, scouting for Earth Power, and Shake makes a really nice play going for Lava Plume again. You know what would have been even better if he went for Rocks on the Trend Switch earlier and then Lava Plume on the Landra Switch. But yeah, that was a nice play and he's gonna go to his own Landra. I assume that Jimmy's just gonna U-turn on knockoff here. Yeah, he U-turned. Yeah, he just made a risky play. I don't think he... So yeah, he just made a risky play in Lava Pluming the opposing Heatran. And I don't think there was ever a world where he was gonna risk his Heatran. But yeah, this the Yancy is... Outspeeds this after the Triskav got knocked off, and I think he's just gonna click Moonblast here. It's a safe play. I can also see him doubling predicting the Scizor, but Scizor's gonna be forced to recover anyway if it switches in here. And if he has HP Fire and he just didn't reveal it yet, like a lot of DNC carry HP Fire, right? Now that I think about it, so if he has HP Fire, I could see him going for it here. And yeah, if I'm Shake, I just bullet punch you all the time. Because you die from this range to HP Fire. Or you might even die to Diamond Storm on a high roll. But I think you should be able to lift Diamond Storm, but HP Fire kills you, obviously. So yeah, if I'm Jimmy, I go hard into Heatran. Yep. And he roos, which is a risky play, but it worked out. So if... I don't know, if he had HP Fire, that would have been bad. But he goes hard into Heatran predicting Lava Plume slash... Like, he didn't want to let his Slowking get poisoned. I can completely understand that. Slowking can be nice. He double poisons, predicting Shake to scout for Earth Power. And yeah, now we are here with Heatran versus Heatran. They both don't have Earth Power, so this is gonna take a while. They're just gonna click Lava Plume for a few turns, so it's kind of PP stall. The thing is, Jimmy wins. Is it a speed tie? Yeah, it's a speed tie. So they both have taunt, toxic, rocks, and the last move is gonna be, yeah, I think it's taunt, toxic 2 on this Heatran, and he already removed the entire moveset, so they have the same moveset basically, I assume. And yeah, we're gonna be here for a few minutes. I don't know, he switches into Slowking finally. Now he's taunted, so that means he can't get poisoned, and if he gets burned that would be better than getting poisoned. But he's left over Slowking, which is, yeah, ABI plays 90 minutes, he just said. Which means this could be either Nasty Plot or Dragon Tail. Like, the main reason to run Slowking over Slowbro is either if you want like a Spadef wall, because it obviously has better Spadef, or if you want the utility of Dragon Tail, Nasty Plot. It can set up Nasty Plot and Trick Room, but on this team, I don't think he's Trick Room. This team is not, I mean, it's not super fast, but it's not like, it doesn't really look like a, like it needs Trick Room support to me. Cause he has a Scarf Land, he has a Manaphy, he has priority on Scizor and Breloom. Like, I don't think he needs Trick Room at all. I assume it's just gonna be, if he's a Calm Mind, Scald, Slack Off, and Slyshock Slowking, I don't really get it, because if you run that set, I would just run Slow Bro probably. Cause you get better physical defense, and like, I know there's a Slowking, like, people have run Fist Death Slowking with Calm Mind and Fist Death Slow with Calm Mind, and if you just run a little bit of Spit Death on Slowbro, you reach the same spread that Slowking has, but you get some more points in defense, I think. So there's like no point in running Fist Death Slowking. Like, that's what I remember. Maybe I'm wrong, you haven't played Arbiters in a while, but it should be true. Like, I can check after the game for you guys. Yeah, I'll do that for sure. But yeah, he doesn't get the burn on the Tangrowth. I mean, Leftovers, this could still be Thunder Wave or Calm Mind, or maybe three attacks with Slag Off. Scalds again, because the Tangrowth was super low, so I can understand that. And it's looking as decent Spadef, so like, it's not that Gigalion would have done much. Gets the Mew and the burn on the Mew, which is going to be annoying. He's going to softball here. Yeah, he has a softball, I think. I don't think he can afford to knock off on this turn. And yeah, Jimmy knows his Heatran walls this Heatran, so I thought he would go into his Heatran, but he just stays in and knocks off the left. Oh yeah, that's obviously a good play. That's a good play. But yeah, he's that set that I expected. And what's the last move? Oh, Will-O-Wisp, obviously, yeah. Goes into man if he predicting the Heatran, because the Heatran that Jimmy has beats Shaq's Heatran, because he get rid of the leftover. So really nice play, doubling out into Manaphy. And this is a tough turn for Jimmy. Jimmy might have to either sack his Mew here, or he might have to predict Shaq to go for a Tail Zone, pull a hard into the Yancey switch, which would be risky. I mean, Jimmy is already in the back. It's not looking good for him. If he goes into Mew here, he kind of just gives this Manaphy a kill, so it's looking bad for him. If he gets the play correct, which would be hard, the Yancey on a Tail Loader, he would look like a lord. I mean, the Yancey loves the skull anyway, but there's always a chance of getting burned, and it's such a risky play to go hard the Yancey, but I could see him Tail Loading. He doesn't lose anything from just scalding, but the Mew is already burned, so this is why I could see him Tail Glowing. But overall, if I'm Shaq, I would still probably just click Scald here. And I guess, like I said, I assume the Heatran is max speed, max HP, like both Heatrans. They were speed tying. So this is gonna do a lot, exactly, this 2-hit KOs. Yeah, I agree with just Scalding there. I mean, he can Toxic this, which is nice. The Manaphy is a big threat, but the Manaphy already did a lot of damage to him, and it's gonna do even more damage. Like, if he gets the burn here, Ice Beam will kill this. And yeah, now this is in range from Ice Beam, I'm pretty sure. I said Shaq back at it again, I think, in the chat. Shaq back at it. Yeah, Shaq bouncing back for you. Probably picking up a win for US East here. And yeah, the burn helped him out because the Tangrowth was put into range. Wanna see if he had a chance to kill it. I don't think he could have killed it without the burn. I think that's 29 to 35, so that burn didn't matter. Wow, the burn didn't matter unless you get, yeah, the burn didn't matter. What the fuck, I thought it would only do like 22. I mean, I could, yeah, I don't think it matters. He's just gonna Roost or Bullet Punch. Whoa, he keeps making this Roost play. What if the Yancey actually has HP 5 and kills you, dude? I mean, maybe he's just a genius and he gets it correct. I remember, like, in the other game that he played yesterday, things didn't really go his way in the... I think it was Nintendo who made the aggressive play in the other game. Most of the time, got them correct. He doubles back in the Yancey, but it didn't really work out. What was he predicting there? I'm slugging lives any one hit. And does the NC take a score from 76? It might be able to take it if it's a low roll. But he switches out into Mew, and so he goes into Heatran, which means, I don't know if he predicted the Mew, or if he just wanted to have a Slowking back at full regenerator. Yeah, Jimmy's gonna get some leftovers here. Jimmy is... The Slowking is so obvious here. Like, the Slowking is coming at 100%. Does he have anything to predict this? No, he just lava plumes. Like, he didn't really have a good play. Yeah, this game is over, yeah. This game is so over. I mean, Shaq played it well, but if he fired HP 5 on any of those turns where he went for Roost with Scizor, it would have been at least a bit closer. I still think Shaq was in control of the game, even if he lost the scissor. Like at this point, he doesn't really need scissor. Scissor was only necessary as long as the Tangros was around, I feel. Because like he had ways of revenging the Yancy. Like Yancy was a bit annoying to him if he lost scissor, but not super threatening. Like he had Slowking, which can check it. He had Brilliant with Mark Punch, and the Yancy, if it switches out, it has to keep it. It takes rocks repeatedly, so it's not like he can switch around. And the Mew being burned also helps him, and burn obviously still said this multiple times, burn is busted in auras, so it helps him even more, because in Sun and Moon leftovers would be cancelled out by burn, but he burned as more like you basically lose 6% every turn. And yeah, he's just gonna U-turn here. He brought the Lander Hardened Prick in the softball. This is the freest U-turn ever. Like, he's just gonna bring his heat turn, I assume, if the Mew stays in. And if he switches, he gets momentum, or he clicks knockoff. I mean, that's also understandable. It's definitely understandable, because it would have brought down the Mew super low and would have gotten rid of the leftovers, so burn even hurts the Mew more. But I still think I would have U-turned there. He misses Stone Edge, it doesn't really play a huge role. I think they would have done maybe 20%, maybe even less. Yeah, maybe 20%-ish. Just goes for Bullet Punch, wants to keep his scissor healthy, and I assume he's gonna go into a Slowking here, as Jimmy goes into Mew, potentially predicting the Slowking, but he does just go into his own heat turn. Makes a nice mid-ground play in case Jimmy went into Mew. Goes for Taunt, which is just to be safe so that the Mew doesn't go for Softball, which is understandable. And yeah, I don't think Shay should stay in here, because the opposing Heatran still has leftovers. And if he stays in, the opposing Heatran is gonna go back to full. He's just gonna go Slowking eventually, yeah. On the Taunt, oh my lord, stop this man. But he's just gonna spam Scald here, as Jimmy stacks up the Landorus to rocks. Mew is forced to softball here. And yeah, he says GG, it's over. So yeah, he can maybe predict knockoff and go hard DNC, which is another reason why I would just click U-turn over knockoff. Did he just click Earthquake? Yeah, he just clicked Earthquake. That's also an option. Because, yeah, like I said, I could have seen Jimmy predicting knockoff and going into Diancy. Yeah, I do want to figure out real quick the spread that I was talking about. With the Slowbro versus Slowking thing. So I'll pause it real quick and be back with that spread. Yeah, I've played around a little bit with the spreads, and I'm not really sure. But I think it's just if you want more Fist Def or more Spadef. Because Slowbro obviously has that way more huge defense. But, like, especially on the comment set, the way more defense obviously helps Slowbro better than Slowking, because you boost this Spadef anyway with Calm Mind, and you want to be able to take physical hits as well as possible. But yeah, Jimmy's on Team Europe, just to add that information. I think that was Team Europe's first game, and yeah, that took a loss. And I don't actually know the Team USE's score. I think because he lost yesterday ADV, I remember them being 2-1, and I think they were like Shake also played. I think they might be 3-3 or 4-3 now. Let me actually pause and show you. Oh wow, it says they were 5-3, so they are 6-3 now. What really? ABR Flaming Victini won a game. Yeah, obviously I recorded that. ABR lost one. I recorded that. I basically recorded all the games. Brofist won his game, and yeah, Tsunami is now 1-1. Oh, they already updated the score, so that this is already updated with the win that he just had. So they are 5-3 now. Okay, I was about to say that there's no way they are 6-3. BKC is 1-1, and okay, there was a GSC game that they won. I didn't see that, or I didn't really pay attention to that because it's Gen 2, and I don't know much about it. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Cool win for Shake. I think he played it well for most part. Yeah, sometimes, like I said, it could have gone wrong if he lost a scissor to HP 5 at turns by Roosted, but he still played it well, managed a good matchup, even though that AV tank was like, that's not the not even the best counter, especially if he gets skull burned, and he let it get low. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. I'll be back later with ABR versus Faults, and I think Proshporn is playing too. I actually don't know his opponent. So yeah, stay tuned for that, and Dr. signing out. Goodbye.